Good morning, dear students. Till now we have learnt that Vanda Petronsky was a Polish girl, means a person who belongs to Poland, and children made fun of her, especially the two girls, Paddy and Madeline, Peggy and Madeline. Okay, this Vanda Petronsky used to sit in the last corner of the class. The boys also loved to tease her, but on one Monday, she didn't come to school and nobody noticed her absence. किसी ने ध्यान नहीं दिया कि वो आ नहीं रही है. And Tuesday also, the same happened, but still, the two girls, they, after the bell, they waited for her. So no one was very much curious that why she was not coming to the school, means for Monday. Then we have to proceed further. Vanda Petronsky, most of the children in the room 13 did not have names like that. Actually, her name was also very special. In our class also, if we have the name, a child with the name, a different name, very special or related to some rural background. So sometimes children tease such boys with such names. Okay. Here, this is the same case. Because Vanda was a special and unique name in the class, because there was no one else with such a name. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith. कितने अच्छे अच्छे नाम थे उनके. एलन, थॉमस, स्मिथ. और ये क्या नाम, वेंडर पेट्रोन्स की. देर वॉज वन बॉय नेम्ड बाउंस, विली बाउंस, एंड पीपल थॉट दैट वॉज फनी. एक ऐसा ही नाम का एक और बच्चा था जिसका नाम था बाउंस. अब बाउंस क्या नाम है. बट द अदर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द क्लास ऑल्सो थॉट इट अ फनी नेम. बट इट वॉज नॉट दैट फनी और देन पेट्रोन्स्की वाज. जैसे उसका नाम भी इतना फनी नहीं था जितना कि वेंडा पेट्रोन्स्की का था. सो वेंडा वाज अ पोल. पोल मीन्स अ पोलिश गर्ल हु हैड इमिग्रेटेड टू अमेरिका. हर फेलो क्लासमेट्स थॉट दैट वेंडा पेट्रोन्स्की वाज अ स्ट्रेंज नेम बिकॉज दे हैड सिंपलर एंड इजियर अमेरिकन नेम्स. बाकी लोगों के अमेरिकन नेम थे सिंपल. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, देर वॉज ऑल्सो एन अनदर बॉय हु हैड द नेम विली बाउंस. विली बाउंस भी बिल्कुल अलग नाम था, हालांकि उतना फनी नहीं था जितना कि वेंडर पेट्रंस की. दे फाउंड हर नेम टू बी लॉन्ग एंड अनफेमिलियर. ओके, so this shows that those children did not understand diversity and whatever they did was done out of thoughtlessness. वो बिना कुछ सोचे समझे बच्चे चिढ़ाते हैं, बुलिंग करते हैं, तो वो शुरू हो गई. Vanda did not have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean but looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She didn't have any friends but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in a schoolyard at the school as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. Didn't hang right, didn't fit properly. Actually, you must be knowing the game hopscotch. It is a game which children hop into and over squares marked on the ground. You are also playing it. You must be playing. So it is a game. Hop into and over squares. Squares ke upar hop karte hue jo ground par squares banakar hum khelte hain. So she did not have any friends in the class. Apart from it, she used to wear her faded blue dress every day to the school. The most special thing is that she used to wear only one faded blue dress. And even it was not properly clean and ironed. Then the condition of the dress was also very bad. This shows that Vanda belonged to a poor family. It was obvious that a child who does not change the clothes very regularly, daily, like other children of the school did, and she used to wear only one blue faded dress with the even unironed. So it was obvious that she belonged to a poor family. So, ironically, a lot of people talked to her, but she did not have any friends. सबसे बड़ी चीज़ ये कि वो बातें तो उससे बहुत लोग करते थे, बहुत दूसरे बच्चे करते थे, but she did not have friends. Actually, from her tale about 100 dresses. Okay, she was surrounded by a lot of girls, but they were surrounded in the schoolyard. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard. वो उससे schoolyard में बातें करते थे. As she stood watching the little girls playing hopscotch on the worn hard ground. Ground was also very hard, and other girls were playing hopscotch, and she used to stand and watch them. So it was her routine. Then it was very obvious that other children used to make fun of her. She did not get mixed with others. She did not have many friends, though she talked to most of the children, but she did not have any friend. Okay. Then Vanda, Peggy would say in the most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Vanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge, tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? 100. Vanda would say 100. Kya kehti thi wo? 100. Exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, and the little one would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Yeah, 100. All lined up, said Vanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Yeah, all silk, all colors. Velvet too. Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Vanda would repeat sturdily. all lined up in my closet. Then they would let her go. And then before she had gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. क्या होता था कि if someone wears one and the same dress every day, which is even fitted, unironed. So if you ask her how many dresses does she have, and if she replies 100, naturally everyone will make fun of her. So this is the same with Wenda here. Peggy would call her in the most courteous manner as she were talking to Miss Mason. पहले तो बड़ा courteously, politely बात करती थी वो, आवाज़ लगाती Wenda, और क्या करती फिर नज करके दूसरों को, नज करना means to press the hand to another, दूसरों को कोनी मार कर कुछ बात करना. Then means giving a gentle push, nudging, हल्के से धक्का मार के. बट पहले तो बड़े पोलाइटली पूछा, अरे Wenda, tell us how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? तुम बताओ जरा तुम्हारे क्लोजेट में, क्लोजेट मीन्स इन अलमीरा, मीन्स इन योर कबर्ड. सो टेल मी, किसने बोला ये? पेगी ने. पेगी ने पूछा Wenda से, Wenda टेल मी, तुमने बताया था ना तुम्हारी क्लोजेट में, तुम्हारे कबर्ड में कितने ड्रेसेस हैं? देन Wenda's रिप्लाई वाज 100. ओहो 100. ऑल द गर्ल्स वर सरप्राइज्ड टू हियर दिस 100. देन Wenda वुड से यस 100, बट the other girls who were playing hopscotch at that time, they would play, stopped playing. वो रुक जाते थे ये जवाब सुनकर. ये 100. Then Wenda would reply, yes, all 100 dresses are arranged in my closet. All 100 dresses are all lined up. Then she kept quiet. After giving the reply, she kept quiet. Yes, I have 100 dresses. And all are lined in my cupboard. So other girls asked her, what are your dresses like? कौन से कपड़े की है, किस कपड़े की है, what are they like? तो Peggy ने mockingly, ironically उसने पूछा, अच्छा all silk, I bet. हाँ मैं शर्त लगा सकती हूँ सारे सिल्क ही होगी. Because when they saw her that she was wearing only one dress, and they were asking her, yes, do you have your all the dresses of silk? No. Yeah, all silk, all colors, velvet too. फिर भी Wenda ने क्या reply दिया? Yes, all the dresses of different colors, silk, and even of velvet also. Velvet is a precious and soft cloth, very soft cloth. Yes, I have the dresses of silk, different colors, and velvet too. And Wenda replied it repeatedly. Stolidity means calm. Remember, this is a new word for you. Stolidly means very politely, very calmly, and without showing, means showing very less and little emotions. बहुत कम, मतलब चेहरे पर बिना कोई एक्सप्रेशन खास लाए हुए उसने बोला, हाँ all they are lying in my closet, and I have dresses of different colors, even silk dresses, velvet dresses, I have various sorts of dresses. and then they would let her go. So, as soon as she left the place, all girls burst into peals of laughter. सबके सब एक साथ हंस पड़ते थे. किस बात पर? When Vanda replied that she had the dresses of so many colors, even of silk and velvet too. So I hope you have got the gist of what has been taught to you till now.